In this video, I am going to talk to 7th standard students. Students, which lesson are we talking about? Did you remember? We are talking about 3rd lesson, that's animal fiber. Yeah, what is fiber? Fiber is the fine strand-like structure or fine hair-like structure. And we get this fiber from animals and plants as well. The fiber we get from plants that we have talked in 6th standard. You have learnt in 6th standard. In this standard, you are learning about the fiber that we get from animals. Examples for the fiber that we get from animals. Can you give some examples? Sheep, yak, camel, silkworms, etc. Okay, the fiber that we get from these animals we use to prepare different fabrics. Okay, fiber is mainly used to prepare what? Fabrics. The final product of a fiber is fabric. Okay, here in this chapter we have talked about sericulture. Sericulture is the process of what is the subject? The lesson that we are talking about is animal fiber. Animal fiber that we get from goat, sheep, camel, silk moth, yak, etc. Okay, and in the past videos we have talked about the process of getting silk. Silk from what? From silk moths. So what is this? A process of getting silk from silk moths is called what? Sericulture. This is called as sericulture. There are different stages present in sericulture. What are the stages present in sericulture? First, eggs and cocoons. Next, fiber. Fiber is used to make yarn. Here there are different stages involved in preparing silk in sericulture. Eggs are nothing but larvae. larvae of silk worm, silk moths. And after larvae, that becomes a worm, right? The worm is called caterpillar. And the caterpillar covers its body with its saliva by secreting saliva. The saliva becomes hard when it comes out of its mouth, and it covers whole the body of silk worm, and that is called cocoon, otherwise pattu kayalu, and fiber. Finally, the hardened saliva becomes fiber. And here, how do we get fiber? By stifling. What is stifling? Boiling of cocoons to kill the silk worm in cocoon. And to get fine fiber, that's nothing but what? Silk fiber. So this silk fiber is treated with different colors and different chemicals, and that is reeled finally. That is what? Reeled in reeling centers. Okay? Silk fiber is reeled in reeling centers. And different words, also different words related to this chapter I taught you in the last class. In the previous videos, please watch those videos and get continuity of the lesson. Okay, students, especially in this video, what I'm going to talk to you is the next level in sericulture process. What is the next level after getting silk fiber? What is the next level? Next level is that what? Weaving. And before that, I want you to understand, silk fiber is used to prepare silk fabric. And in our Telangana state, a most popular place, a famous place in our Telangana is Pochampalli Silk. You know, Pochampalli is located nearby Hyderabad. What? Pochampalli is famous for producing silk. Producing what? Silk. So Pochampalli is also called as Silk City of Telangana. Okay, Silk City of Telangana. Pochampalli is the village where the silk is produced more, and it's famous for production of silk. Then the place is called Silk City of Telangana. Okay, and here not only this, the next level of sericulture process is weaving. After we get silk fiber, we have to reel it, and reeled fiber is used to prepare fabric. Preparation of fabric is weaving. What is weaving? Weaving is the process of preparing or making fabric. What is weaving? The process of making fabric. Okay, how weaving is done? Weaving can be done by manually or mesh power, you know, manually or automatically. See, to prepare fabric, if it is done by man or manually, then the fabric is called hand loom. What is this? Hand loom. And if it is made by machinery, you know, automatically, in the sense there is no human involvement, the machines make the fabric. So that looms are called, that fabrics are called power looms. Hand looms and power looms. Looms are nothing but fabrics. Okay? Here, not only Pochampally, here the fabric is made, the looms are made not only Pochampally and other places of different states in our country, like Dharmavaram, Benares, Kanchipuram, and Narayanpet. And Kottakota, here I am writing Kottakota, are the all types of silk fabrics. You know, the name of the silk fabric is given based on the name of the place they are produced. You know, Dharmavaram silk, Banaras silk, Kanchipuram silk, Narayanpet silk, Kottakota silk. You know, these are the places where the fabric, silk fabric, is made. Okay students, in the next video we will talk about weaving in detail, how the weaving is done. And in this video, what we have learned, we have reviewed the points that we have talked in the previous class, and also we have talked about what is weaving, and what is hand loom, what is power loom, and where are the places the silk fabric is made or produced, and these are the name of the fabric based on the place they are produced. Like this, these are the points that we talked in this video. And in the next video, we'll talk about in detail about weaving, students. Thank you for listening.